Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So if you saw one of my videos not long ago, I did a video about how to add in emojis into DaVinci Resolve. And right now, there is a new pack from Motion VFX. It is the M Reactions pack, and it is going to take your emoji level a step higher than what I did in this tutorial. So in this video, I'm going to take a look at how the pack works. Is it worth the money? And is this going to make your productions more engaging and fun? All of that stuff we're going to have a look into this video. A quick disclaimer is I did buy this pack with my own money. I don't even think Motion VFX know I'm doing these videos. If you are, please let's connect and let's make a collaboration and do some more. Also, if you are interested in the pack or any of the other packs I reviewed, first off, you can see some of the old reviews. They'll be linked down in the description below. There will also be an affiliation link. So if you are buying from that link, I'm getting a little commission fee, which is kind of nice. Okay. With that out of the way, let's get into DaVinci Resolve and let's start working with emojis and stuff. Let's get right to it. Okay, so here we have a look at the M Reactions pack from Motion VFX, and just very fast, first thing you would notice when you go into your effects and you go into your effects and you go into Motion VFX is that nowhere can you find the M Reaction. And that is because the M Reaction plugin isn't really a plugin if you're using DaVinci Resolve or Avid or Premiere. It's only a plugin if you're using Final Cut. And that is actually a bit disappointing, I think, because where you can put these emojis into your timeline and you can actually customize those. But if you are using DaVinci Resolve or any of the other platforms except Final Cut, you can't do that. So in theory, it is just a bunch of overlays, and they are great overlays, they are great animations and stuff like that, but it's not really the same as if you're using it in Final Cut. Also, you can't really find them anywhere. They don't have a dedicated plugin. They are a bunch of overlays, and you can, of course, import those into your project. However, I would recommend you to go up to the effects pool, and if you do not have your power bins opened, you can actually just go up to the menu here and go into view, and then go down here, and then show power bins. And I already did this, so if I open my master power bin, I imported these two folders. It is a effect folder and emojis folder from Motion VFX. And that's actually the only way you can have them inside of the program. It doesn't matter what kind of a project you're using. You can always find them now in your power bins if you have them in here. And they are quite nice, actually. It's just that you can't customize them like you can in Final Cut. But there is a bunch of emojis and also effects, like balloons and stuff like that. So how can you actually use these? For instance, let's say I want to put in a smiley emotion on this guy. If I were in Final Cut, I could animate the emoji and make it longer and stuff like that. But here in DaVinci, I simply can't. So we have to trick it a little bit to make it work. So first off, let's say I just, for the sake of this tutorial, not to make this too long, just going to take this clip here, but I want the face to be on this guy. So first I need to actually make the animation of the face. And it's super cool that it's transparent and everything, but it's also a bit limiting. So let's say I want to use this part of my emoji. And it's okay for now, it's okay here. However, as soon as I'm here, it's going to zoom in, and I don't want that. I want this to be the same length as my clip. So there's only actually one way of doing that. Let's take this clip here. I'm going to push Alt and drag. And then I'm going to take this clip here, and I'm going to reverse it by going into the inspector, going to speed change, and push this arrow icon. So now we have this emoji moving, and I'm going to take the first and I'm going to copy that to the end, and then I can just make this fit. So now we have a emoji making it longer that way. So that's the way you could do that. And then of course I'll need to highlight my clip and right click, and I'm just going to do a new compound clip. We are going to call this smiley and create that. So now I'm going to highlight this and right click, and I'm going to make this into a new fusion clip. And with that done, I'll jump into Fusion, because we are going to do this inside of Fusion. So first off, I'm just going to figure out what is what. So by taking the first here, I'm pushing, this is actually my background. So I'm going to take my video out here, and I'm going to put this into the merge. And for now, I'm just going to take off this merge clip. So now we have the media and the media out, and I'm going to push Control Spacebar, and I'm just going to put in a tracker. Let's see, let's add in a tracker, not there, but we're going to add this in between right here, like that. And of course, now we're just going to add in a tracker. Let's say maybe we could track, I think this headphone would be a good tracking point, at least that in theory it would be. So let's just quickly track this by just pushing forward. And now DaVinci will do its thing and is going to track the headphone. And we're going to use that tracker point whenever we're going to add in our emoji. And again, DaVinci is pretty good at tracking, so hopefully this will be just fine. Like that. Okay, it's done tracking. So what I want to do now is I want to go into the operations, and in the operations, I'm going to change this to match move. Then I have my emoji here, and I'm going to add that into the tracker. And now we have the emoji here. What I then need to do to control my emoji, we can see it's actually pretty good tracked to the headphones, but I want it to be on the face. I need to take in a transform node. I'm going to put in the transform between media 2 and the tracker 1. And now I can simply just go up here in the center here and move this around, make it like that. Maybe I want this to be like a little smaller, something like that. And pretty fast, we actually made this little effect here using a tracker inside of Fusion. And of course, you can still just use the different effects or emojis just by dragging them down from the media pool and putting them on top of your clip. And then, of course, you can make them longer, just like the way I showed you. But there we have something like that, which is kind of fun. And of course, I mean, I know this is meant more for social media and stuff like that, but sometimes you just want to put in a funny face, or you want to put in some confetti over the clip like that, and that is totally doable, and you can easily do that. Also, another benefit actually of having these like video files is, of course, you can add in effects on top of this. So if we take this heart, for instance, like that, we can go up to our effects, and let's go into this, and I'm just going to go into my open effects, and I'm going to search for a drop shadow, for instance. So I'm going to put that on my clip, and now we are adding in a drop shadow on our effect here, which is kind of giving more depth, and that's pretty cool. And you can do that by all of them using different effects, putting on top of your effects layer, if that makes any sense. So again, a cool way to use these emojis and backgrounds. And of course, you can do stuff like this as well. So overall, this is a nice pack for motion VFX if you want to do like small emojis and stuff like that. However, I do miss the ability you have in Final Cut to customize your emojis and make them do whatever you want. Here, I'm kind of stuck with what is pre-made. And even though that is nice in some cases, I just like to have the option to do whatever I want to do. So I do hope in the future that Motion VFX are going to update this for the other platforms, so you are going to have the same possibilities as the guys using Final Cut. So also, according to the price, it is a bit pricey, I think, because you are only going to get a bunch of overlays and no customizability. So in my book, that is a shame, but the pack itself is nice. It's just a little too expensive, I think, for what we are getting right now. But if they do a update, totally worth the money. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.